Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Montana. Good afternoon for you.
Good afternoon, Sara.
You look wonderful. Lovely to see you again.
Thank you. It's great to see you. You look fantastic.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone is enjoying this beautiful event so far, World Happiness Week. I've lost count on what day we're on because the hours have been very, very wonderful and long, and the speakers have just been amazing. And we have a really, really special treat for you today. We have Diana Ringquist here, who is going to be doing a live art piece for us. So I'll just give a brief intro to Diana. Diana Ringquist is the founder of the Modern Goddess Project, an initiative to empower women to shift from everyday to the extraordinary. She created the unique and transformative storytelling intervention and art form called Storylines, and I'll have her speak about it in a moment. Diana has so far lived in North America, Africa, and Europe, and delights in meeting new people and learning about new cultures. Diana is a lifelong learner, earning multiple degrees and certifications in a variety of different fields. She's a coach and speaker and author and artist as well, because why not? And she is currently pursuing her certification in positive psychology. So we welcome Diana. I'll ask her to speak in a moment. And in about a half an hour, we're going to move her into a workshop where she's going to create one or more live art pieces for us, inspired by talks from this event. So we're so grateful to have you, Diana. Thank you so much for joining us. Would you care to say a few words about yourself and tell everyone a little bit about how Storylines is born?
Well, thank you, Sara. You did a great introduction, so I don't have a whole lot more to add. Thank you. Storylines was actually something that I created just a little under a year and a half ago. It was something that I was in a period of deep grief. My mother had just died, and I was seeking a way to memorialize her. Mm-hmm. It was not a grief that I was willing to share yet or discuss. And so I wanted to do something symbolic. And I started playing with her name, and I hated every single thing that I did with it. I'm not a particularly girl, flowers and butterflies person. So I was playing around with it, and it was late at night, and I was exhausted, and I was filled with grief. And I finally closed my eyes, and I said, "Mom, what do I do? Help me out here. I need something."
Wow.
And I started to doodle, and all of a sudden, the story came out. What was important to her, what she always told about herself, the parts of her life that were important. And so I began to draw her story, and it came out in a linear fashion, and ended with, and her legacy continues. And that design I cleaned up, and I actually had tattooed on my forearm right here.
Amazing.
She's always close to my heart. And the tattoo was done 6 weeks to the day after she had died. And it's an art form that I've used with many individuals to memorialize celebrations, successes, traumas, losses, and it's really incredibly wonderful way to express without necessarily opening up and having to use words that can sometimes be difficult.
Because sometimes we have so many different layers of feelings to process, and that's such a beautiful way to you know, allow, create a space almost to capture them all and just, you know, memorialize, honor them in that moment, in that art form. It's such a beautiful thing. Can you tell us a little bit about what that feels like for you as you're meeting with a client that's asking you to do a piece, for example, or for this event? What does that feel like for you? Do you see it visually? Do you just get a feeling, and, you know, is it sort of an automatic flow through you?
When I'm in the what I call gathering stage, when I'm getting information, when I'm trying to find out what parts of the story are really important, what are the key elements?
Right.
That part is more kind of intellectual and heady. As you said, a lifelong learner. I'm a student of the world, so I have to research.
Conceptualizing.
Exactly. I have to research. Yeah. I have to understand. But then when I start to actually draw the storylines, it's something that flows. It's a moment of, there it is, draw it now, quick, because it's just, it flows forth, it just sort of erupts. And
I love that.
In one of the storylines I'm going to do today, there is actually a point, it's what I'm calling it my storyline, of how I was preparing for all of this, and there's a point where nothing came. And it's actually in the storyline itself when I was at that point, and then when I broke through and things came forward. But it's, in some ways, it's almost like a trance state sometimes. And it's something that I am planning to continue to work with and develop further with the help of a friend of mine who's a psychologist, so that it can be used as a tool, as a therapeutic method with individuals, and something that I can teach to others in time.
How beautiful. Well, thank you so much for being here and for sharing your story, Diana, and also for sharing this beautiful opportunity to see an artist at work. So I encourage everyone in about a half an hour to hop into, you can actually hop in and hop out of Diana's session as you go to different workshops and keynotes and just see how the art piece is coming along, or multiple art pieces if you end up creating more than one. Thank you again for being here. We're honored to have you and to see your beautiful works and the energy that flows through you. May it flow through you freely and easily today.
Thank you. I'm very humbled to be here, so thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day.